represent the 11th Middlesex District. And I want to also thank you very much for holding this hearing this morning and giving us this opportunity to express our concerns and feelings. And I also want to thank DHCD for being available and willing to work with legislators around the solution to the change in regulations. And I also want to thank the Mass Law Reform, Greater Boston Legal Services, and Mass Coalition for the Homeless, who have been very much a participant in all of our discussions and have kept us surprised of some of the situations that were actually described by Representative Provo. So and I guess I would just say or mention that so the Committee on Children, Families, and Persons with Disabilities did put together, we did go through all the regulations one by one, and I'm not going to go through them all now. And I really am grateful that we've been able to work together to actually improve, I think. And I think there are some substantial improvements to many of the regulations. There's still a couple that we would like to continue to work with you on. And I'm just going to mention one, which I think has already been mentioned. It is a grave concern, and that is the whole issue around imminent risk. And I, you know, I did have an opportunity to serve on the Commission to End Homelessness back in, I think it was 2009. The whole idea was that we would be ending homelessness by, I think, 2012, that we would be finished with all of this. And I also come to this as a healthcare professional. I'm a nurse, and so I'm very concerned about the clients that we're actually talking about and the need, the healthcare needs, for example, that we need to be thinking about as well as everything else. And I also really have learned more, I think, about the goal here of the administration, which is to get permanent, more permanent, move toward the whole idea of having more permanent housing where families don't have to move around, and there is a more sustainable opportunity for families. But I would agree with Representative Wolf in that I think there has to be sort of a transition period, and I feel like we're not quite there yet. We have done some good things in the legislature. You know, I think RAFT is something that's particularly good, and I know that in situations where families are needing to double up or they are doubling up, there's an opportunity there for the use of some RAFT money to perhaps help with the rent in some of these apartments, and so we've been working with you on that. But I don't think we're there yet, because there are very clearly many families, and we hear about them all the time, that aren't ready. They're not, there isn't, and I think Senator Eldridge mentioned, you know, about the whole need for more housing. We just don't have the stock at this point. I wish we did, to really move people into a more permanent situation. And I understand that, you know, there is a lot of cost involved in terms of keeping families in shelter, and I met a woman recently who has 8 children. She's using 2 motel rooms a month. It's costing $2,000 a month. She has no ability to cook. It's the use of a microwave or, you know, a toaster oven and things like that. So, you know, it really is important for us to figure out ways to house folks who have families, and to, again, as everybody has already said, make sure the kids are in the same school, they're not having to move around, that their health care needs are taken care of, and education as well. So I would urge us to continue our conversations and to continue our, and still very much like to continue to work with the advocates, with the administration, with the legislators, to see what we can do to be more inventive, maybe, in terms of how to approach this group of families that are really at imminent risk. And I guess I would also recommend that we maybe put some of our funding toward case management, you know, so that we, when we have these families who are at imminent risk, that there are case managers available to those particular folks. New York City that seem to be, they seem to be managing this whole homeless situation maybe better than we are, and, or at least they have some ideas of how we could work, particularly with, I think, those families who are at imminent risk. And I understand that you have perhaps been thinking about talking to the New York City folks, and I would urge you to do that, because there are lots of, I mean, we, I think we have to be innovative here and think of what to do, because we are in a situation where it's, it really is a desperate situation for some families. And again, I agree with the goal of getting families into more, a more sustainable home housing situation, but we need to figure out how to do that. And until we actually have a way to do that, I think there has to be something available to those families that is shelter, that does protect them, and yet work with them to figure out what the next steps might be, and particularly because we know that the housing is not all there yet for our ability to really manage all of these folks. So again, I would also just urge you to think about continuing to work with legislators and the advocates so that we can come up with ideas to help, and particularly help those who are at the imminent risk, so they don't have to be in a situation where they are at imminent risk or living in a place that's unfit for human habitation. To me, that is just very, very worrisome, and we should be able to catch them before that happens and figure out a way to do something for them. Thank you very much.
Thank you.